It's time for PBL with Mr. S.
Hey kids, Mr. Swinside here. How you doing? I'm really excited to talk about kind of a shift that we're making in social studies for the rest of the year. It's the way it looks, the way it feels, even the way it sounds is going to be different. So it's not going to be referred to as social studies for the rest of the year. We're actually going to be calling it project-based learning, or PBL, with Mr. Swinside. That's what I'm going to be teaching the rest of the semester. Now, are we still going to be learning about Minnesota history? Absolutely. Are we going to be talking about it? Absolutely. But the way we learn it, the way we talk about it, and what we do with it, how we apply our learnings, is going to be different. So what we're going to be doing is project-based learning. What is that? Sounds cool, right? A lot of times, I'm just going to say PBL, not PB&J, although that's amazing too. I wish it was called PB&J, but that's another topic. So project-based learning, it's something you may have heard of, is something that you may have even done, or at least a light version of it in previous years. So how many of you have created a little trifold?
Pick me! Oh, I know, me! Okay, fine.
Or a little presentation deck talking about something you've learned, something that you've studied, maybe a scientist, where you put on the board all the things you know about them and all the things that he or she did or they did. Sound familiar? So that often gets called project-based learning, but really all that is doing a project. It's kind of the dessert, if you will. What we're gonna do is we're gonna get into the main course, the stuff that really fulfills you and really like the meat or the, well, whatever you want for a main course, right? Meat, veggies, it's the main course. That's all we're excited about. So here's what project-based learning is. It's an experience, first and foremost. It's an experience in which students are pulled. They're pulled through the curriculum. So we're still going to be looking at Minnesota studies and Minnesota history. So it's an experience in which students are pulled through a curriculum by a meaningful question to explore, an engaging real-world problem to solve, or a challenge to design or create something. So we're going to ask a meaningful question. And we're going to relate that meaningful question to something that's important to us today, right? We can connect history, we can connect the past with our current life and what's going on and make it relevant. And that's what we're going to do. And then in the end, you're going to demonstrate what you learned by creating a high quality product to present your work to other people, right? So that's what it is in a nutshell. That's just the start of it. What's cool about this is PBL is kind of messy, right? Like we talk about in the room how our room is always a little bit noisier, and I'm good with noise and I'm good with chatter as long as it's productive. This room is going to be noisy and it's going to be full of chatter, and we're going to have stuff all over the walls. We're going to use all the whiteboards, and we're going to use poster boards, and we're going to put all our ideas up, and we're going to collaborate. And we are going to, just so you know, for you kids that are at distance learning, we're going to get you involved, right? We're going to figure out how to bring you into the room without bringing you into the room. So more to come on that. I will be sending an email out to all the families, just explaining a little bit more of what project-based learning looks like and what we're going to be focused on. So I know it's a lot to take in. We're going to spend a lot of time just introducing it, talking about it when we get back in school. We're going to go slow because there's just a lot of pieces and components to talk about. So pretty jazzed about it, pretty excited. I hope you are too. If you have any questions, you can always email me, and we will see you soon.